So the group has been discussing the interplay between competition policy and trade policy. We have found that competition policy may be helping the development and the implementation of trade policy, but sometimes competition policy is an obstacle to the development of trade policy. We have found, for example, that competition policy and trade policy are complements when we talk about government procurement. Competition policy can help trade liberalization, can help ensure that a sufficient number of bidders compete for procurement projects, and in this way, it makes collusion much more difficult, and it also limits the scope of corruption. In this sense, both policies are complements. But we have also found that in some cases, competition policy is used strategically in order to promote the interests of domestic firms at the expense of foreign companies. In that way, competition policy can create a barrier to entry, a barrier to trade, can lead to protectionism in domestic markets, and can generate distortions in the international competition, can distort trade flows, and can distort investment flows. What we've been discussing then is how to address these issues. How can we promote the use of competition policy in those instances in which competition policy helps trade liberalization efforts, and how we can deal with the problem of the strategic use of competition policy. Some of the policy proposals that we have discussed are relatively easy to implement, and we are very optimistic about them. Some of the challenges are somewhat more complicated, and that's what we will need to work in coming weeks. Overall, it has been a tremendous experience sharing the ideas and thoughts with people, with highly competent people, with significant experience, with concrete examples in mind. It's been a very active and a very thought-provoking meeting, and I look forward to further exchanges and work together with the rest of the members of the group in order to complete our proposals.